Hello students, we will be studying Girvan-Newman algorithm to find the communities in a graph. Girvan-Newman technique is used for detection and analysis of community structure or a graph where we will eliminate the edges with the highest number of shortest path that passes through them and we are able to get the. Let's understand the Girvan-Newman algorithm. Repeat until no edge is left. We have to visit each and every node and each and every edges. Now we will calculate the edge betweenness for every edge in the graph. We will remove the edge with the highest edge betweenness. We will calculate the edge betweenness for remaining edges and then we get the communities. Let's understand it by example. For the given graph, calculate the betweenness centrality for the edges. Solve using a Girvan-Newman algorithm. These are the 6 nodes in a graph. We'll start with the A. A is connected to the B and D. So we'll apply the BFS algorithm, breadth first algorithm. Then B is connected to C and E. Then E is connected to B as well as D. So we are going to connect it to D also. Then F is connected to C and E. Now this is the level 1 from where we are actually going to start. So B is a distance where is a one path exists between A to B, that is as we are writing 1. There exists a single path from A to D and A to C, so we are writing it 1. But if you want to visit the E, we have a two paths from A, B, E and A, D, E. We are considering it node A and we have to calculate the path between A to B. There exists a single path. The path between A to D is 1. The path between A to C is again 1. That's why we are writing it 1. We have to calculate the path for E. So there exists a 2 path for E, A, D, E and A, B, E. So we are writing it 2. So how many paths are for F? Yes, as C having a 1 path, E having a 2 path, definitely F having a 3 paths. A, D, E, F, A, D, E, F. And A, B, E, F and A, B, C, F. So there is a 3 path. We are adding it 3 here. Now we are considering it like a water flow of a tank. So as there are 3, the 1 flow goes to C. So it will be 1 by 3. There are 3. So 1 flow is going back to C. That's a 1 by 3. That is a 0.33 is a weight of this edge. Similarly, we can find out the weight of the between the E and F, that is a 2 by 3, because 2 flow is going to E. So 2 by 3 is equals to 0.67. Similarly, the weight flow for the edge is between C and B is a 1, because whole path is going there from C to B and the flow which is received from C to F, that is 0.33, which comes down to 1.33. Similarly, we can find out the for the DLs, ED or DE, what we get the 1 as whole flow is going there, but plus the flow is coming from EF, that is a 0.667, which comes down to 1.667. As E is divided into 2 paths, so what we get is divided by 2, so we get the 0.835 flow is going from E to D. Similarly, we can find out for the BE, which is as like the DE. We get is 0.835. We can find out for the A to B, that is a 3.165. Adding these two numbers, adding 1 to this, we get a 3.165. Similarly, we can find out for the A to T, that is a 1 plus 8.835. That is a come down to 1.835. Now, considering B as the node where the flow is coming out, so as per the BFS, B is connected to 3 different nodes, that is A, E, C, and AE is connected to D. So we are writing it D here. Similarly, F is connected to E and C, so it will be here. Now we find out the distances between them. So B to A, we have 1 edge, B to E, we have 1 path, B to C, we have 1 path. If you want to calculate for D and F, we have a 2 paths. Like for D, we have BAD and BED. Similarly, for F, we have two different paths. We calculate D flow from D to A, which is a 1 by 2, and for E to D, it is again a 1 by 2, which comes down to 0.5. Similarly, we can calculate for the AB, DBE, and BC. Now, considering C as the node, and from there, we are applying BFS algorithm. We get this kind of structure and we can calculate the different values for all the nodes, which comes down to 1 for F, there is a 1 path, there is a 1 path for C to B, there is a 1 path for A, there are 2 path for E and 3 path for D. So we can calculate all the edge weight. Similarly, we can find out for the D also. So D is connected to A and E, and we are able to calculate all the values, all the path values, and all the weight of the edges. Now similarly, we can find out for the E, which is as good as the B, because structure for E and B is similar, so we get all those values. We can calculate for F also. So calculating all those values, we are going to place in a one table for better understanding, and we calculate the edges and their edge betweenness, AB. So values AB, which is available from all those graphs, will be taken, and those are sum up. We get some values. Now we are going to add all those edges, AB, then BC, then CF, EF, DE, AD, and BE. Now we have all these values calculated. Now we have written over the graph. Now we understand it's an undirected graph. As undirected graph, the weight will be, it's a to and fro. So we have to consider the half weight of it. So we will half the weight. So all weights are half. Now we understand the larger distance between AB and BC, DE and EF is 4. We can divide it into two parts between AB and DE by drawing some vertical line. This is the graph is split. Again, same is happening on the right hand side portion of the graph, deleted due to highest edge weight. And we got three different regions in a graph. So this is how we calculated the communities in a given graph. So there are three communities, AD, BE, and CF. Thank you.